In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Bye.
mother of Jesus, his birth impacted her life in significant ways as seen in the scripture. His birth left her with much to ponder. To ponder means to think deeply. She must have thought deeply about the things that were happening to her as a result of her baby's birth, and she hid those memories deeply in her heart. Memories like giving birth to her son in a stinky old stable. Memories like the visit of the shepherds, the support and understanding of her husband Joseph, given to her prior to and during the time she was giving birth to her son. What it would be like to watch her son's first steps. What would be the first words he would speak. How she would care for him the first time he smashed his finger while helping his father Joseph in the carpenter shop. The list would go on and on, I am sure, as Mary, the mother of Jesus, treasured and pondered all these things in her heart. What about you and me? Do we ever think deeply about Jesus and who he is and why he was born in a stable? Do we ever consider the cross, and are we reminded of the pain he suffered for our sakes? How has the birth of Jesus impacted our thinking? Has the birth of Jesus given you much to ponder or to think deeply about? Have we, like Mary, treasured up all the things about Jesus and pondered them in our hearts? And then there is Joseph, the man who was chosen by God to be the provider and the earthly father of the Son of God. Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for it is he that shall save his people from their sins. From this, Joseph would understand that this child was not to be of his flesh and bones, but that this son born to him and Mary would be the Messiah. Stop and think about the moment Joseph held this child for the first time in his arms and the thoughts that must have run through his mind. How can it be that this baby in my arms, sleeping now so peacefully, is the Son of God who the angels have told me? How could this be? I know he is not of my flesh and bones, but yet, please God, let this child be the son of my love. Why me, God? How can I, just a simple carpenter for all my life, now raise a king? How can this be? This seems to be such a strange way for you to show your love for humanity and to save the world.
Just an ordinary girl. Savior in his arms. He must have thought, why me? I'm just a simple man of dreams.
He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make a careful search for the child. As soon as you have found him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
Yes.
with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. It is clear enough to see that the story traces the quest of these magi to find the one who was born king of the Jews. They arrive in the palace, they receive directions, and they are coached by the king. They visit Bethlehem, and they pay homage to the child, acknowledging that Jesus is the promised Messiah and a source of joy to the nations. But there is more here than a visit to a child who would be king someday. These magi worshipped him. That was the intent of their coming. This child, Jesus, was far more than a future king. Only if he is divine would he be worshipped. And this makes us aware of the primary mover in this story, God. He is not specifically mentioned, but the presence is obvious. The star has guided the wise men to Bethlehem. The prophecy had recorded exactly where Messiah should be born, and the dream warned them to return home a different way. Without this divine intervention, they would never have come. The scribes would not have known where to send them if they had arrived, and they would certainly have fallen into Herod's trap without the warning. God moving in the lives of the Magi is the true cause of their actions. We might also want to consider why gold and incense and myrrh were brought to Jesus by the Magi. Biblical commentaries often see symbolic meanings in the specific gifts. They say that gold was a gift for a king. But in the Old Testament, gold was also the proper setting for the sanctuary where God dwelt among his people. The incense was for deity, as the sacrifices in the Old Testament were sprinkled with it, and the myrrh was a preparation for his suffering. Matthew makes no such points out of the gifts, so we probably should simply say that these were costly gifts, and so they were certainly appropriate for a king. They speak of the homage of the Magi, and they would have been welcomed by Joseph and Mary, who were very poor. Jesus, your birth was prophesied. You came and walked upon this earth. Your glory we have seen. You are the one and only King, and now you are living in our hearts, and you are in this place right now. Jesus, light of the world, you shine upon us. Shine upon us right now and reveal yourself to us this very moment as we worship you in this holy place together.
Oh, Jesus, Son of God.